The one thing I love about Vassar is it is not afraid. The people you meet here, they are going to make a change in the world. They are ready to take you on. They're going to ask you the tough questions. They're going to push you forward. They make you better than you otherwise would be, and I love that. The study of grand strategy is how do you connect the ends that you want with the means that you have. And it's a fascinating study. We go at it by looking over world history. We begin with Sun Tzu and Thucydides. We move to Machiavelli. We study Kant, constitutionalism, the Federalist Papers. We look at Lincoln. We look at Martin Luther King, Aung San Suu Kyi. Some of the great moments in history where we've seen shifts in how a population tried to achieve whatever their goal may be. We look at scientific strategies, cultural strategies, social change strategies, grassroots strategies. In the second semester of this program, students are given actually practical problems that need a grand strategy to address. We've taken on problems that have been as diverse as the crisis of the oceans, or Middle East strategy from the U.S. perspective. Some of them are pretty controversial. But we throw students into this saying, remember what you have learned. What did you learn about the Thucydides? What did you learn about how Lincoln dealt with these kind of leadership challenges? And how could that maybe help us in this moment? And what I've heard from students who graduate from this program is it's given them confidence. Suddenly they feel like, hey, wait a minute. Maybe I have a good idea, and maybe I could dream just as large as to deal with the crisis of the oceans. Oh, I love teaching. The most rewarding part of teaching is having a student who in the beginning of the semester really just does not understand something. You try to explain it in a new way each time you see the light bulb go off. That moment is the best moment. You just feel as if you've had real communication. You have actually communicated something and you have a relationship. So I have students who I've known for 30 years that now are just doing amazing things. In fact, several of them I have thought multiple times, okay, they were my student, now they're my colleague, eventually they're going to be my boss. When I was asked by the Clinton Foundation to work in Ethiopia with them, I had never been to Africa. I had been doing healthcare my whole life, I'd never been to Africa. They actually emailed me on a day of my sabbatical and asked if they could come and talk to me about working with the Minister of Health in Ethiopia. Honestly, I thought, I'm just going to triage this to another faculty person. I'm going to convene the meeting, I'm going to get all the Africanists in the room, and I'm just going to push this project to one of them because they know this. They understand AIDS, they understand what the Clinton Foundation might be doing. But in fact, as we met together around the table, it was clear what they wanted was someone who had been a hospital administrator but was an academic now and could think about improving the quality of these very low-level hospitals in Ethiopia. So I said yes. Honestly, it was the best decision of my life. It completely changed the way I look at things. It helped me understand how you can really achieve a lot with very limited resources. I learned a tremendous amount about leadership by working in this setting. It is a place where you cannot lead alone. You lead in groups. They collaborate. They believe if you have a disagreement, stay at the table. Stay at the table and try to work it out, particularly at the grassroots local levels. And this is something that I think we could really learn from in America, where often leadership is conceptualized as an individual trait. It's something a person's good at or they aren't. But isn't it much more subtle to think of it as a group effort that you're leading in a shared governance model, honestly? You're leading in a way that together you're identifying the objectives and coming up with the strategies that can execute on those objectives. Much of what I've learned about leadership has really been informed by some of these very grassroots programs I've been a part of. There's something special here. If you look back at some of the core values that are at Vassar, it's about agency, empowering students. Students feel as if they can really make a difference in the world. To me, Vassar was the ideal combination of a heavy intellectual place that also wants to act in the world.